Hi there.
Lunchtime at Orono High School.
We have cheese, veggie, or pepperoni today.
You'll find fresh fruits and vegetables. All parts of a well-balanced meal.
You're welcome.
But one thing you won't find, peanuts.
We decided to go peanut-free.
And not just in the cafeteria. About 10 years ago, the entire middle and high school buildings became peanut-free zones.
The kids share common space, you know, the lockers, locker rooms or library, and it's like, might as well make them feel comfortable and safe wherever.
Food service director Ben Jacobson says there are a dozen students and staff with severe nut allergies. To prevent a potentially deadly incident, school officials took a proactive approach.
So you might as well get out in front of it and prevent it that one time. Because it doesn't matter if it's one time, it's still a child.
About 1 in 13 American children have some sort of food allergy. That's about 2 in every classroom, something staff in RSU 19 see on a daily basis.
There's nothing on the menu that somebody doesn't have an issue with.
Nutrition director David Layton says across the district, between 6 and 10 students in each school have some sort of food allergy or intolerance. High school staff do serve nut products, but there's a special peanut-free table set aside in the cafeteria.
They are young adults. They should be able to be a little bit more self-disciplined. They know if they have issues.
Dealing with special dietary restrictions comes at a price. Layton says it's cost him at least $700 more this school year alone to meet the specific needs of the students, money he won't get back.
The kids come first. It is a financial burden, but that's what we have to do.
A Bangor allergist says it's an increasing problem for everybody.
The number of people who are having allergic reactions is in fact increasing, because when you and I went to school a long time ago, it wasn't such a big issue.
But he says there's a better way to tackle food allergies.
We're over-responding, which is what we always do. Rather than shun a good food source, we should be proactive and prevent people from developing that allergy.
He says to do so, you have to start at a much younger age.
If we could introduce important staple food items like peanut butter under a year on a regular basis, we could at least probably eliminate or dramatically decrease the incidence of peanut allergy.
And as for what local school districts are doing?
It is better to be safe than sorry, I guess is what school departments have decided. It's hard to argue against that.
Reporting for ABC 7 and Fox 22, I'm Kayla Fish.